Hello. In this video, we will be going over common types of TDR faults. These faults include opens, shorts, and soft or partial faults. As a review, anything that changes the transmission line properties of the cable or other device under test is going to change the TDR waveform. So any change in the geometry of the conductors to each other or change in the dielectric constant of the insulator material will result in a change in the TDR waveform. Here's an example of an open fault. It appears as a pulse upward because it reflects in phase with the test signal. These kinds of faults appear naturally when the cable isn't connected to anything and often indicates the end of the cable. Here's an example of a short fault. It appears as a pulse downward because it reflects out of phase with the test signal. This will appear anytime there's a short. I've connected a 1,000-foot cable to the CT100. Now, short or open faults that are at the end of long lengths of cable will show long, shallow reflections, like this. This is a 1,000-foot cable with an open at the end of it. As you can see, the fault is long and shallow. Okay, now the CT100 is scanning two short cables that are connected by a connector. Connectors will also show up as a fault on the trace. For example, this trace is scanning a BNC interconnect. You can see the waveform makes a spike. Also, connector damage or corrosion will change the profile of the connector, so it's useful to keep records of your scans and compare the present with the past and see the condition of your connectors. Finally, here's a cable with many small soft faults. These include kinks, dents, and cuts. They show up as small bumps, each of which represents changes in the local capacitance and or inductance of the transmission line. Most of the test signal is carried through these small faults, but a small amount is reflected back at each fault. Small faults can be important for two reasons. Although any one small fault may be below, and sometimes well below, the noise budget of the particular communication systems in question, the noise resulting from multiple faults can add up and ultimately lead to increased bit error rates or poor RF performance. Also, small faults can be indicative of a problem that might worsen with time and possibly lead to system failure at an inopportune time, so it's often wise to track them. To conclude, that's an overview of common types of faults: open, shorts, and soft faults. By gaining experience, you'll be able to recognize these easily. If you have any questions, send me a message or leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching.